What's up? I'm Taylor from HSM Lake Forest, and welcome to Church Online. It's the very first week in our Series 1, and we are so excited to be with you guys for Church Online. In this series, we are talking about how with God, all it takes is one person to change the course of history. Each week, we are going to look at how God uses one person to make a huge impact on the world, and how He can even use each one of us to do the same. This week, we are looking at the story of Gideon found in the Old Testament book of Judges in chapters 6 through 8. Gideon is an unlikely hero, but God still used him to deliver Israel from the oppression of a group of people called the Midianites. Before we really dive into Gideon's story, we're going to worship through music, and then after the message, we'll pray together. Let's worship together.
I know you'll never fail. I Have you ever considered the power of one? We don't often think of one person or thing having much power by itself. One piece of bacon is never enough. Owning one pair of underwear? Well, that's just gross. When your mom only lets you have one cookie after dinner? That's no fun. When you think about it, it's pretty easy to underestimate one. Most of the time, one seems so small, so insignificant, but there is power in one. And with God, all it takes is one person to change the course of history. In this series, we're going to look at how God uses individuals all the time to make a huge impact on the world and how He can use each one of us to make big impacts of our own. Each week, we will look at a different character from the Bible, but before we start, it's important to understand that none of the people we are going to look at in Scripture acted completely alone. They partnered with and relied on others along the way. But big movements often start with one person. God seems to have a pattern of grabbing the attention or the heart of one person, who then invites others onto the adventure. This week, we are going to take a look at one of the most unlikely heroes in the entire Bible. It's the story of a guy named Gideon, who went from hiding in a valley to leading an army to victory. If you want to take a deeper dive into Gideon's story, you can find it in the Old Testament book of Judges in chapters 6 through 8. Let's take a look at his story. So Gideon was a young man from the nation of Israel. Israel was constantly finding itself in trouble because it had a habit of ignoring what God wanted. It was in a cycle of obeying God and experiencing His blessings, then disobeying Him and finding itself at war and usually under the control of other people. And that's what's happening when we meet Gideon. Israel is being harassed and threatened by the Midianites. God had allowed Midian to take over Israel because of their constant disobedience. Now, you'd assume this means Gideon must be a great leader, a skilled warrior, and somebody highly qualified for the job, right? Well, wrong. Gideon was none of those things. In fact, when the angel first appears to Gideon, it says this, "Greetings, mighty warrior." Gideon's response, "Excuse me? I think you have the wrong guy. I'm the weakest member of the weakest family in the weakest tribe of the entire nation of Israel." But God didn't have the wrong guy. The angel tells Gideon that God is going to use him to deliver Israel from the Midianites. Understandably, Gideon is having a hard time believing this, so he asks God for some proof. Or to be more accurate, three pieces of proof. Gideon lays out a fleece and asks God to have the morning dew show up only on the fleece, but not on the ground. So God does that. Not convinced, Gideon asks God to make the ground wet from the dew in the morning and keep the fleece dry. Done. But Gideon was still not convinced. This guy really didn't believe God could use him. So Gideon asks God to do the opposite one more time, to make the fleece wet and the ground dry in the morning. God does it again. There's no denying now that God is asking him to lead Israel's army. Gideon accepts his role and gets ready to lead Israel to freedom. Gideon's army has thousands of men, plenty to feel confident against the Midianites. But there was one problem. God didn't want Israel to think they defeated Midian on their own power, so God told Gideon the army was too large. To get the numbers down, God would give two tests. No, not that kind of test. Test number one was simple. If you were scared, go home. Of the 32,000 soldiers, 22,000 of them went home. God still thought this army was too big. Test number two. God told Gideon to take the army to get a drink of water and to separate the soldiers into two groups. Group number one, those who knelt to drink the water. Group number two, those who cupped the water into their hands. Afterwards, God sent the first group home, leaving a grand total of 300, yes, 300 soldiers to go battle against Midian. Now, you may think an army of 300 going to battle against thousands of men is an impossible task, and you might be right, but nothing is impossible for God. God told Gideon to take the 300 men to the Midianite camp in the middle of the night, to surround the camp, then all at once start smashing jars and blaring trumpets. Gideon's army does just that, and in the chaos and confusion, the Midianites end up fighting and killing each other. And that's the story of Gideon, the weakest member of the weakest family of the weakest tribe who helped save an entire nation. There's a lot we can learn from Gideon's story, but let's focus on two main things. First, Gideon's story reminds us that God sees something in you that you may not see in yourself. Judges 6:14 through 16 says, "Then the Lord turned to him and said, 'Go with the strength you have and rescue Israel from the Midianites. I am sending you.' "But Lord," Gideon replied, "how can I rescue Israel? My clan is the weakest in the whole tribe of Manasseh, and I am the least in my entire family." The Lord said to him, "I will be with you, and you will destroy the Midianites as if you were fighting against one man." In Gideon's mind, he was the very last person qualified to rescue Israel. But God viewed Gideon as a mighty warrior. God saw something in Gideon that Gideon couldn't see in himself. And God sees something in you. You may not see it, but in you, God sees just what he needs to help you do something amazing. And that leads us to the second lesson from Gideon's life. God uses ordinary people to do extraordinary things. The Bible doesn't tell us a whole lot about why Gideon felt the way he did about himself, other than his status among his family and tribe. But there was certainly some stuff that happened that caused him to feel that he was the weakest of the weak. Maybe you can relate. When you look in the mirror, what do you see? Who do you see? Maybe you see a teenager who comes from a tough home life, has made mistakes, has doubted God. Maybe you have been bullied, ridiculed, and made to feel like you are the weakest of the weak. Maybe you simply don't believe God could or would want to use you to make a difference in this world. Maybe you just don't feel like you are up for the task. You don't have any special skills or gifts. Well, guess what? God is in the habit of using ordinary people to do extraordinary things. There was nothing special about Gideon, and there's nothing special about most of the people throughout history who God has used. God loves to use ordinary people. People who have messed up, people who doubt, people who are afraid, people like Gideon. People like you to be the one to make a difference.
Let's pray together. God, thank you so much for this time where we get to learn about you and your story that you put in the book of Gideon. Father, I pray that you give all of us times this week where we have the courage to do amazing things to glorify you. In your holy name we pray, amen. This week, we hope you're encouraged that God sees something in you that you may not see in yourself. He knows you are able to do extraordinary things. Our hope is that you would find confidence and assurance in that. If you want to dive even deeper, feel free to read through the story of Gideon again in Judges 6-8. Well, love you guys. See you back here for week 2 of our series 1.